My name is Donnie. You suck at Photoshop. You hear that sound? It's the sound of nobody clapping for you. Let's say you've been gone for a while and you narrowly escaped a homicidal attack and you found solace in a remote location where you thought you would have enlightenment and peace and quiet, but in the meantime, you discover that the fun stick that your ex-wife has been breaking records with embabied her, and so 4 years later, there's a four-year-old maniac running around who is hell-bent on destroying your legacy and stealing your intellectual property and running up attorney bills with a lawyer who clearly works for a larger organization. And you're getting emails like this.
You're trying to stop me, Donnie Hoyle. I'll destroy you and everything you stand for. Please, come at me. Just give me a reason to ruin you.
We need to take care of this ASAP, and we're going to do it with Photoshop. So, let's open up an image. We're going to create an advertisement for our attorney. This is the trade that we agreed upon for services rendered. And we're going to... Hey, Putai, we've stopped... Please stop playing the flute. This image says that why would I ask you to stop playing fruit? Stupid monk. This image says, I'm a badass attorney, and I just blew up a courtroom with my mind, and there are bits of litigants and pieces of courtroom flying in the air, and I'm coming for you, law. And that's sort of the action that we want to evoke and get people to be excited enough to believe that he's a good attorney. So what we're going to do is we're going to create more action in his body. And so we've got the attorney on a separate layer, but you'll notice that in the background, the attorney is part of the background. So we're going to have some trouble there, and we'll have to come back and do that in a moment. But let's duplicate this layer so we can come back to it. And in the meantime, we're going to create action with this attorney using a technique called puppet warp. Did you just pee-pee? Did you just pee-pee? I heard you. Just take a deep breath, get a wet nap, swab it up. Let's do some grown-up Photoshop. It's not that hard. Our cursor has turned into this pin. We're now looking at the toolbar for puppet warp, and we're going to pin yellow balls where we think there might be joints. So on shoulder, elbow, wrist, neck, head, shoulder, elbow, wrist. Just pinning joints. It's okay. On the knee, ankle, foot, pinning joints. And we're also going to put joints on the briefcase. And now, when we select one of the balls and move it, it moves the parts. But oh, Donnie, look what it's doing. It's moving my flaccid lawyer goo leg with it. Just shut off your question sprinkler and we'll fix it. Go up to expansion where it says 2 pixels and change it to 0. And you'll see now that the mesh conforms to the bitmap underneath. And so when we move the balls, everything moves along just fine, and we don't accidentally grab additional lawyer parts. And so we can now create a little bit more momentum in his body to say, hey, I'm getting ready to dash in and file an affidavit and bill somebody 1/12 of an hour for my time. All right, go up here and hit accept. And now when we turn on the background, we'll notice that our attorney has a lot more action and momentum. But Donnie, there's the lawyer's still on the background, and we're going to have a silence contest and go. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my original lawyer layer. I'm going to command select, and that's going to have the original selection, which will go around the lawyer on the background. We're going to go to select, modify, expand, go by about 4 pixels, and now we're going to say edit, fill, content aware, and Photoshop's going to think it through, and it's going to disappear the lawyer from the background. Now, it needs a little bit of cleanup, but that's nothing that you can possibly do. But when we switch on our newly adjusted lawyer, he covers up most of the stuff. And just like that, we've added a little more action and drama. And to finish out the ad, we have a headline, maybe actually start to make it look a little bit like a movie poster, just because we really want to trick people into thinking that there's something to this guy. QR code, of course, everything is required to have a QR code now, and a lens flare, which just makes it that much more sexciting. And so, in the end, what we've created is simply an advertisement that looks like a movie poster in the hopes of tricking people into believing that it's something that they should be excited about. Use the magic wand tool and select the white background on the phony billboard. Select our ad layer. Click the ad layer mask. And now unhinge the mask and the artwork and select edit, transform, distort to squeegee the ad into the billboard. And most assuredly, nobody would ever pick up on this ruse that we didn't really buy the ad space. Right?
You suck at Photoshop.